Welcome to The Advocate, your Sunday reminder that important conversations are among the necessary tools for a saner society. I'm asking today, as a people, what do we actually want? Comfort is talking about gender issues in what she terms the new man. Felix is once again talking on the issues of effective leadership. And finally, Dolapo talks on why startup businesses fail. Today, expect a mix of seriousness, laughter, and jabs, and we are here to please you after this break. What do we want as a people? Few weeks ago, on a Tuesday evening radio program, State of the Nation, the host Emmanuel Odeyemi and co-host Bolaun asked callers to state the qualities of the ideal president Nigeria needs. Out of scores of callers, I dare say less than three callers addressed the question. Many of the callers, however, called to complain about how ineffective President Buhari is, using unprintable words. So today, again I ask the question, what do we want as a people? We are angry with the government, so we decide to boycott Anambra elections. Wow. How does that affect federal government? We are angry with what we call imposition of a governor, so we decide to kill ourselves in retaliation. When the killings were going on in the East, FG was accused of ignoring the East, saying, if such killings were going on in the North, government would have responded. So government sends troops to the East. We turn around and say, government is militarizing the East. We call President Buhari a tyrant. We, the same people, turned around and called him a weak president. I might not be the best in English grammar or comprehension, but just thinking, can a tyrant be described as weak? Do we know that politicians in Nigeria seem to always and only care about themselves? So look at the rate of defections, even before the political transfer window opens in 2022. I'm just wondering, if there's so much cross-carpeting, defection, et al. Among parties right now, what will happen in 2022 when the political transfer window will officially open? Many great governors have failed or performed less at the national level. Which questions are we asking Mr. Peter Obi, who I believe should be a chief following Nigerian standards? Have we queried his knowledge of Nigeria, his relationship with other tribes? Have we checked how many people from other tribes in Nigeria he interacts with? How much influence does he have in other states? Have we queried his emotional intelligence, asked about the economic beyond China effect? There are a lot of questions we need to ask, but are we asking? By asking these questions, we are not seeking to disqualify him, but rather letting him know that the people he wants to lead have souls and they have soji, like we say. Asking the right questions will further fortify him for the office. What do we want? The topic we discuss, is it what we want or what politicians are discussing? Today, for example, we're all talking about Anambra elections. That's great. It's a state in Nigeria, and we all must know and participate in events happening around us. But wait a minute. Are we discussing it because we are concerned or because it is what politicians are currently singing? Do we know that last week the Federal Executive Council approved NNPC's request to construct roads in every region of Nigeria? Have we asked how this will be done, knowing that NNPC is now full-fledged limited liability company and no longer government-led? The maestro, Alison Desiane Maduike's belongings, were listed for sale. The properties were listed as follows: Properties located in Banana Island, Foreshore Estate, Ikoyi, Lagos, including 18 flats and 6 penthouses, 125 wedding gowns, 13 small gowns, 41 waist trainers, 73 hard flowers, 11 suits, 11 invincible bras, 73 veils, 30 braziers, 2 standing fans, 17 magic skirts, 6 blankets, 1 table blanket, and 64 pairs of shoes. And all we could talk about were the bras out of all the properties listed. So I ask, when the FCC wasn't selling off properties openly, we complained. Now they are, and we're accusing them of being trivial. Bras. Had they not listed the bras, I'm sure by December, someone would have come out to accuse EFCC chairman of not listing the bras because he has given them to his girlfriends. EFCC had listed over 80 properties as at May 2021 belonging to the minister. Did we bother to ask why 67 were not listed? What do we want as a people?
Speechless. Well, you always say this, Nigerians should focus on the main matter. The heart of the matter is the matter of it. What do we want? Our values. It boils down to our values. That's like we said.
Yeah.
Values. As much as possible, Nigerians, let's stop being distracted. I said something about the last election, for the last debate of the gubernatorial candidates,
yes,
for the ongoing Anambra election.
Yes.
And two of the prominent candidates were busy. I'm not going to mention their names, but you know them.
You know the prominent.
This one was accusing this, saying some things about this one. This one was responding. None of them could actually spend that energy. Forget about their personal aggrandizement here. Focus the energy on what does the state want. It's all about I must get it by all means, even if it means pulling him down to climb up. So our values, let's not get distracted as a nation.
I'm sure you spent a lot of time talking about the bras as well.
I think what threw me off was the 125 wedding gowns. That one was throwing me off. But I think what do we want? The country is already tough. The country is hard. Mm. When people see like hard issues, they tend to stay on the surface because they know the deeper they get, the more depressed they get about the whole situation. Mm. So to keep your mental sanity in this part of the world, in this environment we find ourselves in, we tend to cruise a lot. Mm. So everything, like what she has, everything they listed is real, is a deep issue that we should talk about, corruption and everything. Why does she have all this? And we should ask those questions. But by the time we start to probe, we know they won't give us the answers we want. We know we'll just be shouting, just screaming. It affects the mental health. Mm. So it's better to cruise around and say, oh, she has a bra of 1.5 million.
Yeah.
Why does she have that bra of
And that's even the question. And that's even what's worrying. Because nowhere in all that I've seen, nowhere has the value of the bra been stated. Any value that has been put on the bra today are speculations.
Oh, wow.
They are figments of people's imagination saying, okay, it has a diamond, it has a gold. Nowhere was it listed, okay, this is the kind of bra it is.
Oh.
These are just things that were probably, I'm just assuming, that probably found in a house or mm-hmm. in a shop in one of the properties that were seized or something.
Mm-hmm.
Because you have so many trainers, waist trainers and all that.
The issue here, Kayode, is that what you are trying to do, you are trying to direct our focus to the matter, the crux of the matter. If you like, we can't tell people how to spend their in money.
What they want to buy, exactly.
If you want to buy invisible, what do you call it?
Invisible.
I saw a panties and a bra on... I think one magazine some time ago of $1 million. If you want to do that, good luck to you. But the question is, how did you get the money? Is it our money?
Exactly.
If it's our money, then we have an issue. But if it's your money, if you like, buy the whole
boutique. Comfort in Abuja. Maybe you should tell us first of all what invisible bras are.
The question, what do we want as a people, is very valid. I would write it on... the issue of mental health. Do you know how we have been battered in this country? We have been so battered that honestly, we don't know what we want anymore. And this is a clear example of what our leaders have done to us. Now, having said that, it doesn't mean that we still don't have a role and a part to play in where we want to get to. Because either way, these are hard topics and somebody has to talk about them. We keep bringing out the fact that the percentage of the people who are in power and are leaders is about 1%. Okay, you know what? If we're going to be generous, let's even say 10% of us. That means 90% of us are not in active leadership. But we're all leaders where we are. Mm. So these are questions that we should ask. But what do we want as a people? We want good governance. We want to be able to be secure. Mm. We want to be able to go to school. We want to be able to place our businesses in the right places. You know, we want to be free of harassment.
Yes.
But do we have a conducive environment for it? The answer is no. Can we get a conducive environment? The answer is 50-50. If we as a citizen are not ready to work towards it and sacrifice enough to get what we need to get, even with our mental instability, then what do we want as a people? We already have it.
That's it. And I really agree with you on that one.
I just want to buttress what she said. Like, if our government, if we are able to hold our government accountable, or if they are able to be accountable for what they've been doing so far, it will be easier for us to like ask them, like tell them what demand. We want and demand and things. But this is a government that we know that they have no accountability whatsoever.
Okay,
and you probe them, it's like you're mad.
Even going beyond this, even before this government came into power, the government before that we all say, okay, maybe they were a sinner. What did we demand from them? Those are the questions. So it's not really about this government or that government.
Did you think the government before this was saying that the government before this introduced the old cruise idea with the first lady doing whatever she was doing?
So
they introduced the old cruise.
So now coming to that topic that you just said.
Coming
to what you just said, which is where the issue is. So now if we say that the government, like what you said, the government before this wasn't saner than the one we have now. Mm-hmm. So why then do we always hammer on, this is the worst government? Why don't we just say, okay, you all are not giving us what we want. This is what we want. And it comes down to the idea of what do we want as a people. Last week, there was this report on two civil servants, not politicians.
Mm-hmm.
Two civil servants were arrested by the ICPC and... they were arrested, and when they did the probe on them, the two of them, amongst the two of them, they had 301 houses, properties. Yes.
Civil servants.
Civil servants in Abuja. And these houses were not... my brother, that's the concept. These houses were not in, what do you call all the outskirts of Abuja? Comfort cannot force with that. They were in Meitama, they were in Wuse,
choice area.
They were in choice areas. 301. Between two civil servants. Wow. So, you see, what we want as a people goes beyond what we are asking the government. It's about we account being accountable, we demanding, we charting a course. I stated about a radio program, where someone said, the presenter said, okay, what kind of president do we want? So that we start making noise now, let's see how we can get the kind of president we want. And majority of the people that called, like you rightly said, because of our strait of mind, was all cruise. This government is the worst. We know. Let's agree on that. What do we then want? Hardly did you find anybody that could itemize the qualities we want in a government. And that's how bad it is.
Well, may God help us. But we have to help ourselves. There's a lecturer in my school that will tell us, if each time we say we want to pray, he will tell us the gods will not do what you should do for yourself.
That's it.
And the thing is, it all boils down to our values. Who are we? It's like we should change our orientation. You don't have to steal money to live a good life.
That's it.
And the fact that you live a good life does not make you a thief, necessarily.
And to bring it home, the fact that you have money doesn't make you a credible person. And that's what we fail to understand. Exactly. Now, once you bring money, you are a ogre.
Money is not. Well, by the way, Comfort has refused to tell us what an invisible bride is.
She will tell us when we come back. The new man is on Comfort's Mind after this break.